The secret ongoing war for Web3. Should you be worried that big technology companies and venture capitalists are deciding the future of the internet on your behalf? Will Web3 give you true freedom and privacy, or will it make you a mere controlled customer? Are big technology giants and venture capitalists waging a clandestine war over who will own you while using the internet? Stay tuned, because seriously, you should be concerned, and I will tell you why. Welcome to the World Econ News. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, like this video, and hit the notification button to get updates and information about the latest international economic news items. I'm about to enlighten you about a very important global economic, social, and liberty issue that is all about you. Yes, you, the internet user. The generous and cool Jack Dorsey, the co-founder and former CEO of Twitter and current CEO of Square Inc., became the unintentional whistleblower of a very real ongoing conspiracy by venture capitalists and technology billionaires about who will shape and control the next generation internet, aka Web3. It all started when Elon Musk, yes, again, it's Elon Musk, who doesn't sleep, it seems, tweeted, "Has anyone seen Web3? I can't find it." Seems more marketing buzzword than reality right now. This innocent tweet by someone merely looking for something that has not been created yet created havoc and shed light on a secret, clandestine, ongoing war over who will shape and monopolize Web3. Jack Dorsey responded to Elon Musk by suggesting that it was already under Andreessen and Horowitz's control. He tweeted, "It's somewhere between A and Z," Dorsey said, in reference to A16Z, a venture capitalist firm that was created by entrepreneurs Ben Horowitz and Netscape co-founder Mark Andreessen. A16Z is one of the most successful and influential venture firms in the world. For a while now, it's been piling significant early investments into many new big hits such as Coinbase, Oculus, Slack, Roblox, OpenSea, CryptoKitties, NBA Top Shot creator Dapper Labs, and Airbnb. It's important to note that the firm heavily backs blockchain, crypto, and the development of Web3's applications under the oversight of Horowitz and Chris Dixon. It's also important to note that the firm is asking the USA government for help in shaping Web3, while it is doing little to nothing in consulting the 7.5 billion people on this earth. They're also completely ignorant to the fact that the internet is not just an American matter. Jack Dorsey caused the venture capitalists of A16Z to lose their minds. He strongly criticized the venture capitalist industry and its investors who, as he said, will eventually dominate Web3, the next generation internet which will be based on blockchain. His tweet said, "You don't own Web3. The VCs and the LPs do. It will never escape their incentives. It's ultimately a decentralized entity with a different label." Mark Andreessen responded by blocking Jack Dorsey on Twitter. Jack responded to the block by tweeting, "I'm anti-centralized venture capitalist owned, a single point of failure and corporate controlled lies. If your goal is anti-establishment, I promise you it isn't Ethereum." First, allow me to take you for a short tour of the internet since its inception. The internet was invented in the 1970s by the US Army to protect its nuclear weapons from hacking for the purpose of controlling its nuclear rockets. Then, it realized a single computer controlling all the rockets during the Cold War was a bad idea because some lunatic might press enter and cause Armageddon. So they built a decentralized network of multiple computers instead. This concept of decentralized computers gave birth to Web1, which was created by Tim Berners-Lee in 1990. The first version of the internet, Web1, was 1. Decentralized, meaning it was powered by regular computers by regular users. Number 2. Open source, meaning anyone can build on the web. Number 3. Read-only, meaning publishing content required technical skills. Web1 was a decentralized infrastructure where anyone could publish information of any kind to anyone in the world without the permission of central gatekeepers. Now let's move to Web2. In 2000, Web 1 began to slowly fade away as Web 2 manifested into reality due to the appearance of platforms such as the easy-to-use new version of Microsoft Office, AOL, YouTube, Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, WhatsApp, streaming, etc., resulting in the masses joining the internet to get these free services for personal and business needs, such as communication, streaming, gaming, selling, buying, working, and entertainment. Web 2 simply made it possible for anyone on the face of the planet to become a publisher. No technical skills needed. Okay, to the hard part, Web 3. As of this moment, Web 3 is an obvious mystery. Now, don't lose me here. I said obvious because it will be heavily dependent on three-dimensional interactions. A realm of metaverses. Some of these metaverses will be connected to some extent. It's already happening. Bill Gates announced recently that in as little as 3 years, most corporate business meetings will be conducted in three-dimensional environments. As of right now, the process of shaping and defining Web 3 is extremely undemocratic and controlled by billionaires. This means that in the future, the super rich will simply keep becoming much richer, while we, the people, will have to pay for their new riches. This should sound an alarm because, economically speaking, no one should own the internet and it should be a source of fun, entertainment, play, learning, sharing, and most importantly, a source of income for all, without exception. This begs an even more important question, the question of which Jack Dorsey brought into the light. Where on earth do I, you, and the 7.5 billion people out there fit into this battle? It's hard to put an exact dollar figure of how much the internet, aka the Internet of Things, IoT, is worth, or how much it contributes to the global GDP. But here is something interesting you must know. In 2014, Cisco CEO John Chambers said that he believes the Internet of Things to come will create $19 trillion in economic benefits and value over the next decade, meaning between 2014 and 2024. Some experts believe that the actual figure is as much as $40 trillion. Yes, the internet is a major component and driver of the global economy, and you were left out of these mind-numbing figures. And now these figures are growing, and again you're being left out and not even politely consulted. It's widely accepted by experts and human rights advocates that if Web3 turns out to be just another centralized internet with a decentralized facade and controlled by a few technology giants as it is now, then it will be a contributor to increased global income inequality and possible poverty. You might think that the technology giants who moved the internet into the servers and cloud servers spent trillions, but the truth is far from that. They spent, and continue to spend, at most, tens of billions of dollars annually. Some human rights and civil liberties advocates believe that their online work is under automatic sanctions and is not reaching the masses because it's simply not compatible with these corporations' global goals and the US government's foreign policies. Meanwhile, online racism, bullying, fraud, scams, hackers, and even human traffickers are having an easy ride in the current corporate-controlled internet. The technology and internet giants spend the minimum amount of human resources and money on fighting evil. And what's worse, they're biased when they do. There is even something called the dark web, which is just that, dark, and filled with endless darkness and human misery. The dark web is also a source of economic hardships, since it's the meeting place for criminals who want to rob everyone, everywhere. According to experts in the latest technologies, programming and decentralized everything, the majority of the masses are not aware of this brewing battle or how it will affect their lives, despite the fact that it's all about them, their minds, and their money. Take the following four words and never forget. Free is very expensive. Why? Because all the services you're getting online for free from the endless list of app providers and platforms are not free, and you are paying for them. Not in dollars, but in personal data and content. Your private and non-private info and data are mined. Your online psychological behavior is mined. Your online conversations are mined. Everything you do online is mined by secret, complex algorithms and powerful artificial intelligence programs for the purpose of enhancing your online presence. In other words, to make it easier for you to find what you want and buy it or learn it. Why? Marketing. Look, technically speaking, the internet controllers are not doing anything wrong. They make your life easier, which is absolutely true. In return, they generate hundreds of billions of dollars in revenues and profits through marketing. So please don't judge. It's not a secret. It's in the fine print, and you always press accept. However, you're not being financially rewarded for your services, nor are you given an equal opportunity to access all their services and new innovations. Hence, it's an unfair system that helps the rich get richer and the poor to starve. If you're curious how much the global marketing industry revenues are, well, according to Group M, the annual global marketing revenues are close to $1 trillion. Some experts say the numbers are probably higher. Legal scholars are concerned with the fact that a real decentralized internet will be a jungle, because the more decentralized it is, the harder it would be to regulate it. Hence, it would be littered with hate speech, racism, cybercrime, defamation, while used as a tool for trafficking of sadistic materials related to sexual abuse and even torture, just like the current dark web. They also ask, how safe will it be for teenagers and children? The internet is unlike any other industry. It can exist as a controlled and guarded centralized force on the servers of the technology giants, or on a massive decentralized global network powered by blockchain technology on every computer, small personal server, laptop, tablet, and smartphone in existence. It is safe to assume that governments will have a say on the safety and security issues, hence gatekeepers are inescapable. However, no one said they have to be large corporations. Those gatekeepers can be the online communities themselves. So that's it for this video. Farewell, be cool, stay freaking positive. And if you'd like to stay updated and informed about the latest international economical news topics, hit the subscribe and bell icons. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video.